En nombre de St. Dominic On Stage Musical Company, les doy la bienvenida al último concierto del año de Junior Students Production. Esta noche nos veremos envueltos en las aventuras de la princesa Mérida, quien confrontará la tradición y el destino con la determinación de formar su propio camino en la vida. Se enfrentará a los Lords MacGuffin, MacIntosh y Dingwall, y hasta su propia familia. Sus acciones desatarán el caos y la furia del reino. En su afán de solucionar todo, Mérida pide ayuda a la excéntrica bruja, quien le concede un terrible deseo. El resultado lleva a Mérida a descubrir el verdadero significado de la valentía. Espero se diviertan con las ocurrencias de esta princesa y se dejen llevar por las canciones y bailes para acompañarla en el difícil camino de crecer. Con ustedes, los protagonistas.
Bye. I come in to get you. Where are you, little rascal? I come in to get you. Where is my little birthday day? When I find her, I come in to eat you. Om nom nom. Oh, Fergus, you know I don't like weapons.
Can I shoot an arrow? Can I, please, can I?
Why not you, Superio? Happy birthday, my darling.
Wow.
Now, draw it all the way back to your cheek. Keep both eyes open and loose.
Oh, I mean.
Go and fetch it then.
Oh, Fergus, she's a lady.
Wow, look so light. Is it real?
Come, Merida, come.
We can change your fate.
Come, sweet girl. Follow us.
Follow the wisps.
Merida, come on, sweet. You are leaving now.
I saw a wisp.
A wisp? You know, some say that the wisp will lead to your fate.
Oh, come on, let's be off before we see a dancing star or a giant having a jigger in the balloon.
Your father doesn't believe in magic.
Well, he should, because it's true.
Our destiny is tied to the land, as much a part of us as we are of it. Others say fate is woven together like a glove, so that one's destiny intertwines with many others. It's the one thing we search for or fight to change.
Some never find it, but there are some who are led. The story of how the father lost his leg to the demon bear became a legend. How Merida became a sister to three new brothers. The princes Hamish, Howard, and Harris. More like devils. They get away with murder while she can get away with anything.
She's the princess. She's the example. She's got duties, responsibilities, expectations. Her whole life is planned out, preparing for the day she becomes well, her mother. Her mother is in charge of every single day of her life.
Merida, you must be understood from anywhere in the room, or it's all for nothing.
This is all for nothing.
Merida, you mustn't talk like that. She's your mother.
Bonnie, don't worry.
I heard that from the top. A princess must be knowledgeable about her kingdom. A princess does not complain, does not stuff her stomach, rises early. A princess is compassionate, patient, cautious, clean. And above all, a princess strives for perfection.
But every once in a while, there's a day when I don't have to be a princess. No lessons, no expectations, a day when anything can happen. Mother, I can't change my fate.
Yeah.
You're hungry too, I guess. Oh, it is then.
King, tell us about your encounter with the bear.
Well, out of nowhere, the biggest bear you have ever seen.
Tell us.
His face scarred with one dead eye.
Wow, that's really interesting.
I drew my sword and...
What happened? What did you do?
Whoosh! With one swipe, his sword shattered and shot. That leg was clipped off.
That leg was clipped off. Damn the monster throat it went.
How terrible, my lord. That's my favorite part.
The huge beast was never seen again. And he's roaming the wilds, waiting his chance of revenge.
Bah! Wow, yeah.
Let the beast return, and I'll finish with his target in first place.
Merida, a princess does not place her weapons on the table.
Mom, it's just my bow.
A princess should not have weapons, in my opinion.
Merida, or leave her be, princess or not, learning to fight is essential.
Dinner is ready. I hope you enjoy it. Oh, Fergus, will you look at the triplet plates? Don't let them leak. Boys, you're naughty. Don't just play with your haggis.
My lady, a message for you.
Thank you, Maudie. From the Lords Mackintosh, MacGuffin, MacLockhart, and Dingwall. Their responses, no doubt.
Stay out of my food, you granny muggles.
Fergus, they haven't accepted.
Who accepted what, mother?
Boys, you're excused. Off you go.
What did I do now?
Merida, your father has something to discuss with you.
Merida, the Lords are presenting their sons as your possible husbands.
What?
They have all accepted.
Dad!
What? I, you, she, Elinor!
Honestly, Merida, I don't know why I react in this way. This is what you have been preparing for your whole life.
I suppose a princess does do what she's told.
A princess does not raise her voice. This year, each clan will present a baccalaureate to compete in the games for your hand.
No, it's like you've been preparing me for my whole life. You can't make me.
Merida.
Yeah.
you, Fergus. Her stardust is entirely from your side of the family.
You don't work.
I don't know what to do.
Speak to her, dear.
I do speak to her. She doesn't listen.
Come on, now pretend I'm Merida. Speak to me. What will you say?
Oh, I can do this.
Sure you can.
Right, here we go.
I don't dream that we want to stay singing. Let my hair fly in the wind as I ride through the fine hours into the sunset.
Merida, all this work, all the time spent preparing you, schooling you, giving you everything. I ask you, what do you expect us to do?
You're the queen. You can just tell the lord, princess, you're not ready for this.
Oh, no. No, this isn't going to happen. She's the princess. She must obey the rules.
Merida, I understand this must be unfair, but you are a princess, and your mother wants the best for you. We can't just run away for who we are.
But I don't want my life to be over. I want my freedom.
But are you willing to pay the price the freedom will cost? Your mother is not doing any of this to hurt you.
But it is my life. I'm just not ready.
the four clans gathering for the presentation of Bachelor.
Your Majesty, I present my heir, sir, who defend our land from the North invaders, and with his own sword, stabbed bloody thousand foes.
Good Majesty, I present my eldest son, who scuttled back in ships, and with his bare hands defeated 2,000 foes.
Lord, my lady, I present my son, my treasure. He's the best of all the fighters, the best archer, the most powerful of all, my son. He might be tiny, but don't be cheated by his size.
Come on, who are you cheating?
I present my own son, who was chased by 10,000 Romans, and he took out a whole army with his single hand. With one arm, he rode, with one arm, steering the ship, and with the other, he held his mighty sword and struck down a whole attacking fleet.
Lies!
What? I hear that. Come on and say to my face, are you scared of losing your big hair?
At least we got hair on all our teeth.
We are hiding the bridge, you grumpy old troll.
Do you want to laugh, eh, Dingwall? At him, at him!
All right! Stop it! Now it's all done! You had go at each other, show a little decorum!
I didn't start, it was he.
Oh, my lady queen, I feel terrible. My humblest apologies. Sorry, women know disrespect.
Sorry, love, I didn't, but... Yes, sir. Now, where were we? Oh, yes. In accordance with your laws, by the right of our heritage, only the firstborn or each of the great leaders may represent as a champion, and thus compete for the princess of that bridge. To win their first maiden, they might prove the world by strength or arms in the games. It is customary that the challenge be determined by the princess herself.
Archery! Archery! I choose archery.
Let the games begin.
to me.
Oh, this is so unfair.
Unfair?
You are never there for me. This whole marriage is what you want. Do you ever bother to ask what I want? No. You walk around telling me what to do, what not to do, trying to make me feel like you. Well, I'm not going to be like you.
Oh, you're acting like a child.
And you're a beast. That's what you are. I'll never be like you.
Merida, you're a princess. I expect you to act like one.
I'd rather die than be like you.
No, stop that. Merida.
Oh no, what have I done?
What have I done?
Come, Merida, follow us. Follow the wish. We can change your fate. You just have to follow us.
Merida. I'm Merida.
descendant of Phantom Bridge. Interesting. You look sad. You had a fight with your mother, didn't you?
How do you know that?
Well, I know everything here around the woods.
You're a witch. That's why the wizard led me here.
I'm not a witch, but perhaps I can change your fate. Tell me.
You see, it's my mother. How can I make her change her mind?
I'm a difficult work.
Are you sure you know how to do it?
Last time I did this was for a prince.
I want a magic spell to change my mom. That will change my fate.
Bear? I'm a bear?
Why crafty witch gave me a gummy spell.
A spell? You cast a spell on me?
It's not my fault. I didn't ask her to change her into a bear.
Why did you do that, young lady?
I just wanted her to change you.
Did you hear that? Something not right. Ice all over the place.
There's no point in having a go at me. The witch is too plain.
God, it's unbelievable.
How am I going to fix this?
Everybody, follow me, and you keep a sharp eye.
Here we go, and I'll pass through the castle.
Shh, Mom, you can't go out there. Father and the lords are looking for us. If he sees you, you're dead.
The lords are coming, Mary, and I haven't got my hair yet.
You're covered with fur. It's not like anyone sees you without your royal tiara.
He's like a hound with that nose of his.
Bear! Kids, stay back! Merida, careful!
1, 2, 3, attack!
Oh, you just be quiet, kids.
A talking bear!
Stop it, you three. It's not a beast. It's our mom.
Let's tell our father.
Molly, lady. What is it, lady? Spit it out, Molly. Spit it out.
A bear!
I knew it. I'm going to find that beast and kill it with my own sword.
I need your help.
We need your help.
Please. Please. Okay, you can have my dessert for 2, 3 weeks. Okay, fine. A year. Now, mislead the lords while we escape.
At the second sunrise, your spell will be permanent. Unless you remember these words. Fate can be changed. Look inside, mend the bones home by pride.
Fate can be changed. Mend the bond. What that does mean?
I don't know, ma'am. I'm so sorry. I feel embarrassed for this. Stay with me.
My brave little girl, I'm here. I'll always be right here. Sorry, dear. I think I'm turning into a beast.
No, ma'am, it's my fault, but we have to do this together. We need to get back to the castle. If we don't hurry, you will become a bear, a real bear, forever.
Going to marry your daughter?
No more talk, no more traitions. We settle this now. You are the king.
You decide which one of our sons your daughter will marry.
No one of our sons are fit to marry my daughter.
Then our alliance is over. This means war.
We got to stop them before it's too late.
I know, but how do we get up there and the tapestry with all of them boiling like that?
I got an idea. You just go upstairs and leave the rest to me.
Go and all the rest is up.
Thank you.
It's all right, Dad. Well, you see, I have been in conference with the Queen.
So, where Mauricio then?
She
probably knows there is a dream.
This is a highly irregular. What are you playing as? Where is the Queen?
No stand for any more of this nonsense. Let's see her.
Shut it! Well, once there was an ancient kingdom.
What is this? Why are you saying that?
That kingdom fell into war, chaos and ruin.
We hear that tale, lost kingdom.
Hey, but it's true. I know one now how one selfish act can turn the fate of a kingdom.
No, it's just a legend.
Legends are lessons. They ring with truth. Our kingdom is young. Our stories are not yet legends. But in them, there are bones we struck.
Our clan were once enemies, but when invaders threatened us from the sea, we joined together to defend our lands.
You fought for each other, you risked everything for each other. My dad saved your life.
Hey, and I never forget it.
And Lord McIntosh, you saved my dad.
Yes, you're right.
The story of this kingdom is a powerful one. My dad got you your forces and you made him your king. It was an alliance based on bravery and friendship. But I've been selfish. There's no one to blame at me. And I know now that I have to mend my mistake and mend our bond. So there's no matter of my marriage. I decide to do what's right. And break tradition.
Tell us.
My mother, the queen, feels in her heart that we are free to write our own story. Follow our hearts and find love.
That's beautiful.
The queen and I put the decision to you, my lords.
What?
We play an archery game and the winner will ask for your hand.
A game to win her heart.
The tapestry, mend the bones, stitch it up. We just need needle and thread. Mom? Not now, Mother. Please, I need you. I need your help. Mom?
Eleanor, dear. You were very supposed to solve our little maid's problem. Eleanor. It's coming through. Eleanor, answer me. Maida, what's happening? Where's your mother?
Dad, it's not what you think.
Maida, get back! It's all right. Are you all right, Natalie?
It's just a little scratch.
That beast almost had it. I have to go after it. Now you wait here.
More you, 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 more you,
There was a witch and she gave me a spell.
I will find your mother. I will not lose you too.
Dad, no, you can't. It's your wife, Eleanor.
What have I done?
There is it. Quiet. Be careful, lads.
Back, back, get the beast!
No, get back! That's my mother!
Merita, are you hurt, ma'am?
Are you out of your mind, my lady?
I'm sorry, ma'am. It's all my fault. I did this to you, to us. You've always been there for me. You never give up on me. I just want you back, Mom. I just want you back, Mom. I love you.
I just don't understand.
I love you so much.
Eleanor! Eleanor!
Oh dear.
You're back here!